Our first topic is going to be omics. And omics refers to looking at different levels of cell and molecular biology, and specifically how they're all interconnected. So we have genomics, we have transcriptomics, we have proteomics, and metabolomics. It's a weird one to say. And we'll even talk a little later when we get to genetics about epigenetics and the epigenome. But what I want you to notice here is this idea that everything is connected. So I love this graphic because it shows this idea of systems biology happening at the molecular level. We've talked about DNA and RNA, how that works, and you know that makes proteins. But proteins are going to interact to do chemical reactions, and those chemical reactions are going to be influenced by your environment and what you eat, and all of that is going to basically determine if you are a healthy or sick person. So it's not just your genes that determine if you're healthy or sick. It's not just the environment. It's not just the proteins or how your RNA works, but it's a combination of all of those things. And some diseases may be more genetic. Some may be more protein related. Some may be more environment related. And so different people are studying all these different aspects. And now there's a real important place for systems biologists to look at all those pieces and start to bring them together. Bioinformatics is one of the ways we can do this. And because there is such a volume of information, if you think about 6 billion base pairs in your DNA, it's just too much for human beings to sit down and write and compress and calculate all the information. So bioinformatics uses computers and automation to speed the analysis of very large volumes of biological data. It uses what's called high throughput technology, which basically means really fast computers, robots, and automated sequencers. And through the rest of this lecture, you're going to see videos where you're going to see people in labs with all kinds of very technical pieces of equipment. And that is all engineering and computer science that's being used behind the scenes of the biological analyses to just do a better job of getting us answers to big, important questions. Here at ARC, we actually have a biotechnology program, and one class is dedicated entirely to bioinformatics. So if you are really good with computers and interested in being involved in biology, this is a really neat way to be connected to some of the cutting edge things that are happening in biology. In a minute, you'll watch this video about how math and computer science connects to our understanding of omics and cellular processes.